shooting for the cover of FitnessRx magazine. It's exciting. It's actually a dream come true. A couple years ago, wrote a wish list of my goals, and that was one of the goals, is to be on the cover of FitnessRx. And here I am, and I'm doing it, and it's just such an honor to be amongst all the other inspirational fitness women in our industry.
Nice. Beautiful, beautiful. Small smile.
I am a new IFBB figure professional. It was so exciting to win my pro card because it was really fast. Like the week before, I went back into the NPC. I competed at the Eastern USA's, and I took the overall there. And so right away, I'm going into nationals, knowing that there's one spot available to turn pro, and it happened. And I was just like, oh, you know, honestly, I've been moving so fast. I don't know if I've actually sat down to really think about the magnitude of what's going on, but yeah, I was happy. I was a woman that deep inside, I knew I could get in shape. I was, you know, attractive, decent shape. Kind of like, you know, when you squeeze into your clothes and you can make it work, but I couldn't put the bikini on, and I certainly didn't want to go into the dressing room with those fluorescent lights. It wasn't going to happen. So I had been thinking it over, and I, you know, became a personal trainer, and that gave me the confidence to train myself. I really couldn't afford to pay a trainer. I didn't know what I was doing, so I went to school. After I got my education as a certified personal training specialist, I kind of mentioned my dream to an acquaintance, someone I don't really know that well. And this person said to me, you know, I think you're a little bit too old to get started. Well, that's all it took, because I trained like I never trained before, and I just used that negative, whatever it was, and I made it work for me. And I just have a gift of doing that. And now here I am, shooting for the cover of FitnessRx, and someone told me I couldn't do it. So I just believed in myself, and here I am.
That's nice. I like
it. I love it.
What do you think?
Power, Eva. Power, Eva.
Okay, Eva, again?
So it's springtime, and I'm going to give you a few suggestions about melting the fat away. Do not bring the cell phone to the gym. Rule number one. Switch up your cardiovascular work. Something that has really worked for me is I used to only do low intensity work, and it got me to a certain level, but I carry a lot of my fat on my lower legs, like a lot of women do. So what I did is I started doing high intensity interval training, and that just blasted the fat off. It was in like half the time, and I only did it 2 or 3 days a week, and it totally transformed my legs, my glutes. I could see a little nice line, and that equals looking great in a bikini. '10's the year. I'm gonna be working on a DVD series. I'm gonna educate women and show them how I got my physique. I started from just average 30% body fat, no muscle tone at all, to, you know, really nice fit physique, and I'm gonna give away my secrets in those DVDs. So that's exciting. I'm gonna try and pursue maybe doing some reality television. I definitely wanna transcend over to the television and film market. And I'm just gonna keep doing what I'm doing and step on a pro stage and hope to qualify for the Olympia this year. I feel that I have a connection with people because I am a very down-to-earth person. I don't come from great wealth and things like that. I've had to work very, very hard for the things that I have, and I think most people can relate to that story. Whatever their obstacles are in their life, I feel free to share those things because if in my position I can't help someone else, it's really no use to be in my position, in my opinion, because there's nothing greater than someone being able to change their life somehow by something I've done. I believe the future is gonna bring and manifest the dreams I have in my heart. You know, I'm originally from LA and I have an extensive acting background. I've studied that. That's my passion. That was before fitness. And now I'm kind of thinking maybe it might come full circle. I might revisit that dream again, because I believe that if you have a dream in your heart, you shouldn't let it go. So maybe at that time, it wasn't time for me. Maybe it's time for